Hello children, welcome back. I hope you have read the first two chapters in your history textbook. In this video, let us do the end of chapter exercises from the second lesson. In case you haven't read the lesson or haven't watched the two videos on this lesson, please finish that first and then proceed to the rest of this video. Okay, open page number 24. Match the following. Diwani. What is Diwani? Diwani means the right to collect land revenue. So whoever gets this right, they collect the tax. Next one is Tiger of Mysore. I did not cover this point in my video. Tipu Sultan was known as Tiger of Mysore because once he fought with a tiger and killed it. So we have lots of such stories in our Indian history. So this title was given to Tipu Sultan, Tiger of Mysore. Then Faujdari Adalat. This we already discussed under Warren Hastings, Governor Generalship. So many reforms were introduced, and especially in the field of justice, he has established two different courts in every district. One was known as Faujdari Adalat, the other one was Diwani Adalat. Faujdari Adalat dealt with criminal cases, so all the criminal cases were sent to Faujdari Adalat. Okay, right. Next, Rani Chennamma. We have also seen this. I even showed you a picture. Rani Chennamma led an anti-British movement in Kittur. Okay, and finally Sipahi, and this has become Sipai. Sipai means a soldier. Even now we use this word Sipai. It's in fact a very entry level post in military. A soldier, very simply we say soldier. So I hope this is clear. Match the following is easy. Okay, second question, fill in the blanks. The British conquest of Bengal began with the Battle of Plassey. P-L-A-S-S-E-Y, Plassey, and it took place in the year 1757. I told you this was a very important battle. It was not a big one, I told you already. It was a minor battle from military point of view, but a major one from political point of view, because that was the first important battle won by the British, and that was the beginning of the rise of East India Company. It was in the year 1757. Okay, Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan were the rulers of Mysore. They were the rulers of Mysore. Don't think Mysore means just one city. Okay, Mysore was the name of the kingdom. Okay, next phase. Dalhousie implemented the doctrine of Lapps. L-A-P-S-E. What is this doctrine of Lapps? If any Indian king died without a male heir, then that kingdom was annexed to the British territory. That means if a king has no male children, even if he has a daughter or some other relative, they were not allowed to become his successors. His kingdom was annexed by the East India Company. This was one strategy used by the East India Company, and this was implemented by Dalhousie. Okay, and Maratha kingdoms were located mainly in the dashed part of India. We already know this, in the western part. So they roughly correspond to the present day Maharashtra. In fact, a little more than that. You can say western part, or you can say even central part of India. Okay, I think western is more more appropriate. Next, state whether true or false. The Mughal Empire became stronger in the 18th century. Do you agree or not? 18th century means from 1701 onwards. What happened after that? Actually, Mughal Empire became weak after the death of Aurangzeb in 1707. So many rulers came, but they were all very weak. We don't even bother to remember their names. It has become very weak, not strong. So the answer is, this is false. Okay. The next one is, the English East India Company was the only European company that traded with India. Is this right? Again, this is also false. Why? In addition to East India Company, there were various other companies from other countries like Dutch, Portuguese, and then French. So this is also false. But it was the only company from England to trade with India. But the question is not that. The question is, English East India Company was the only European company. So that is false. But if they say English East India Company was the only British company to trade with India, then it would be true. Maharaja Ranjit Singh was the ruler of Punjab. Yes, this was true. In fact, as long as he was on the throne, the British could not conquer Punjab, but after his death, they conquered Punjab. And then fourth one, the British did not introduce administrative changes in the territories they conquered. Again, what do you say? This is false. They have introduced so many changes. I told you already, the justice system, Diwani Adalat, Faujdari Adalat, these two courts were introduced. Then Indian laws were translated into English. And then they have introduced the office of collector, revenue collector. In fact, district collector was introduced during the period of British. And even now, this post is considered to be very powerful in any Indian district. Collector is considered to be a very powerful person in our Indian administration. Okay, so they have introduced many administrative changes. So these are the bits. Now these are the questions. I'll be giving you printed notes for all these questions, but let us discuss quickly one by one. Okay, so what attracted European trading companies to India? So can you give me some points? Yes, in India, high quality spices were available. So spices, we can say, of course, you can write elaborate answer. Spices like cardamom, then pepper, cinnamon, all these were available in India and they had great demand in Europe. And then cloth, our cloth was very famous. So silk cloth and spices attracted European trading companies, and not only that, they made huge profits on what they bought here and sold in Europe. So the availability of high quality spices and high quality silk cloth and the profits that they fetched when these goods were sold in Europe, this is what attracted European trading companies to India. And the next question is, what were the areas of conflict between Bengal Nawabs and East India Company? We told you already. What happened was, Aurangzeb granted a firman to East India Company to trade duty free. That means East India Companies were East India Company was not required to pay any tax when they traded with Indian people. But what happened was, in addition to East India Company, the officials did private trade. That means the various officials of East India Company, they bought goods in India, but they did not pay taxes to the Bengal Nawabs. So they traded and they used the firman illegally. So the Bengal Nawabs were angry because they were not getting any tax on the trade conducted by East India Company. So that is why the conflict came between Bengal Nawabs and East India Company. And there are other reasons also. Initially, they just wanted to set up small factories. Gradually, they built forts and they employed armed people. So, in a way, they started building up military force in India. Again, that also caused conflict between the Bengal Nawabs and East India Company. The next question is, how did the assumption of Diwani benefit the East India Company? So what is Diwani? The Diwani means, we already saw this, Diwani means right to collect tax. So they got Diwani of three villages. I already told you, Kaligata, Govindapur and Sutanati. These three villages later on became the present day Kolkata. So they got Diwani rights of these three villages. That means they were allowed to collect tax. Now, how did it benefit the East India Company? Initially, they were buying everything in India with gold. But now, with the assumption of this Diwani, they were collecting tax which they employed to buy things from Indian traders. So they could save a lot of gold. Okay. So Diwani was right to collect tax, and with this tax they traded. The East India Company traded with this tax. Then explain the system of subsidiary alliance. Earlier we talked about doctrine of lapse, and before that they employed something called subsidiary alliance. What was this subsidiary alliance? The company, the East India Company, the company gave protection to Indian kingdoms on payment of some money. That means they promised protection to small kingdoms on payment of some money. So what is wrong with this system? They have taken a lot of money, and of course they provided protection, but the problem is that these kingdoms were not allowed to maintain their own army. So whatever protection, it was provided by the East India Company. And we have seen what happened. When they could not pay the money demanded by the company, these kingdoms or parts of these kingdoms were annexed by the East India Company. So they provided protection from other kingdoms, but they themselves have taken away these kingdoms. Okay, so there was no protection from the East India Company. The protection was from other kingdoms. Okay. So it was a very clever method employed by the East India Company. Of course, we have seen other things like doctrine of lapse, and these two actually have resulted in the expansion of British power in India. All these small kingdoms were annexed to East India Company one after the other by invoking subsidiary alliance or the doctrine of lapse. Okay. I think you can write the answer in detail. And then ninth one, describe the changes that occurred in the composition of company's army. We have seen they have employed mostly sepoys, and they were given muskets and matchlocks. These were a type of guns. Okay. And then they have employed European style of military training and methods, European discipline. So it resulted in so many problems, like the sepoys have to live together, they have to eat together, and at that time India has a very strong caste system. People wouldn't mingle freely. Nowadays we all mingle freely and we don't mind taking food together, but in those days things were different. Caste system was very rigid, and because of this European style, all people had to sit together. And they did not like, the sepoys did not like that system, and it caused ultimately what we call the sepoy mutiny. Okay. So you can write down all these points, like Indian people were employed as sepoys. They were given guns and matchlocks and muskets. Then they were forced to live together. They had to go by European methods. Ultimately, it caused a lot of resentment among the sepoys. Okay. So that's it. So I hope you understood the important points. And let us do. After the British conquest of Bengal, Calcutta grew from a small village to a big city. Now it is one of the most important cities in India. This is one of the four important, metropolitan cities. Delhi, Calcutta, and Bombay and Madras. Of course, we now call them as Kolkata, Mumbai and Chennai. These are four major cities of our country. So, find out about the culture, architecture and the life of Europeans and Indians of the city during the colonial period. This is an interesting topic. In your textbook also, so many, items are given. You can go through them. So, from a small village, in fact, from small three villages, it grew into a very big city now. And you can find out about the culture and architecture and the life of Europeans and Indians. So, how they lived in that period. You can use your textbook. You can even search on the net. Okay. And finally, collect pictures, stories, poems, and information about any of the following. Rani of Jhansi, Mahaji Sindhia, Hyder Ali, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, Lord Dalhousie, or any other contemporary ruler of your region. So you can choose anyone. So that's it. With this, we come to the end of this second chapter. In my next video, I'll take up the third chapter.